my thoughts on this England Serbia game. First of all, I want to address the reports or the German authorities discussing how England and Serbia is deemed as a high-risk game because of the trouble that could happen based on, the Serbian hooligans and the English fans. The issues that, they have with alcohol and stuff. The authorities have rated that match from the start as high risk, which is Andreas Schär, the managing director of Euro 2024, said. Which is yeah, that's funny. So I just wanted to bring that up there because I was just reading that right now. Now, as far as this game, I think the big storyline for me is I want to see how England come out and play this tournament. Southgate in the past has, came and played a little defensive in the fact that he's played a back five, or he plays double, he plays a double pivot, to protect the back line. More of a defensive double pivot. I wanted to see what kind of approach he takes because, again, this is the England team, and the back is the biggest question marks with this team. When you see the fact that there's no Harry Maguire, so you're gonna have an experience in the back with Mark Gahey. That's gonna be the partner, center back partnership, Mark Gahey and John Stones. That there's huge inexperience amongst that back four. That left hand side is gonna be Kieran Trippier and Mark Gahey. An untraditional left back, a right back playing left back, and a center back playing his first major international tournament games. I think that's a weak part of the team. And I think, does Gareth Southgate slip back into his pragmatic ways and plays, plays a, I don't know, a Conor Gallagher next to Declan Rice, play more of a double defensive pivot to protect that? Or does he? I don't see this happening because he didn't really test this out much in the in the friendlies beforehand. But does he potentially revert back to his 2020 18 days or his knockout stage 2021 Euro days, where he potentially goes with the back three, a back five, back three formation? Is that a possibility for this English team? That's also something that's going to be interesting for us to watch, in my opinion. In my opinion, I'm very interested to see if they do that. Now, this is a Serbia team that I think will be able to threaten this English inexperienced back line with the fact that you have that triangle of Tadic, Vlahovic, Mitrovic. You have the ability of Tadic to make the late runs into the box. He has a capacity to score a goal. He has a capacity to find that ball in behind to play a teammate in. You have Vlahovic. He gives you a little bit of more of that finesse type of striker. Just pure ability to play tight spaces, find openings, little creases, and take advantage of it. Then you got the direct nature of Mitrovic to take advantage. There is no Harry Maguire playing here, so there's not that big muscle of Harry Maguire. So I think Mitrovic, he's gonna fancy have chances being able to play physically against a John Stones. I think he's gonna, I think he's gonna enjoy himself. I think he's gonna get on the ball on the end of crosses. His direct nature, the amount of goals he scored this season in Saudi League, I think he's gonna cause that England defense trouble, in my opinion. I definitely think so. I don't think he should be disrespect. He should be. He's not gonna be disrespected, because England, they know. He played a lot of his football at Fulham. A lot of these players are Premier League players. They know the caliber of player that Mitrovic is. But can he find themselves in the right areas at the right times? And can the Serbian players find them? I think Milinkovic Savic, he's gonna be very important, limiting the amount of, limiting how Bellingham, Rice, whoever is that third midfielder, whether it is a Kobbie Mainoo, a Gallagher, or whatnot, or a Phil Foden. He's going to be very, very important in terms of dictating play. And if they do go with a Phil Foden and they play that open-ended midfield, I think it's very important for Milinkovic-Savic and the rest of the Serbian midfield to really take advantage of the lack of defensive ability amongst the midfield, the lack of a guile in there. And I think it's going to be important for them to be physical with them because, again, you know, I think if they do go with Phil Foden in that midfield, I don't think there's much defensive presence in there with the fact that Bellingham, he naturally is more of an attacking midfielder. Declan Rice, he's kind of transitioned from being more of a six to more of an eight now. He naturally, by nature, likes driving the ball up the field and, you know, leaving his center halves a little bit more exposed because of the fact that he's really transitioned from that six to an eight. I think, you know, that Serbian midfield needs to take advantage. I think Dusan Tadic needs to take advantage of that coming, dropping down into the pockets of space that's left between the English midfielders and their center halves, because you can really take advantage of that space. Now, England, with the attackers that they have, you know, Phil Foden, Harry Kane, Bukayo Saka, you know, it's going to be a massive test for the Serbian back line. But again, if you go back to Serbia when they played against Brazil to open up the 2022 World Cup, you know, they were in there with Brazil. Now, they couldn't get much going forward because Brazil just took the ball and they really dominated it, dominated the ball and just had, you know, controlled possession of it. But they were very stout defensively. And I think if they come with that defensive spirit, with that defensive tenacity, I think they'll have a chance to really threaten England on the transition. Because I don't think England could take the ball and really make you suffocate the way Brazil made them suffocate and eventually make them tap out. I don't think England is capable of doing that. I do think Serbia has the ability to hold on and to get the ball, you know, to find themselves in the right areas, to be dangerous and lively areas, and really make this England team work defensively. I really do. I think this is going to be a fascinating game. And it's going to be interesting to see. I think England do have their weaknesses. And, you know, I think England are going to kind of go, I hear a lot of people, they want England to go for it and to say, okay, look, their back line is sus, so just try to outscore teams and win the European Championship that way. You know, eventually that will catch up to you. I don't think that recipe is going to work for England, you know. I think they're going to be bitten. Now, whether or not they'll be bitten in the back by Serbia, and do the Serbians have the quality to do that, I don't know. But just going with this notion of, okay, then, you know, your defense is questionable, just outscore teams, I don't think that's the right way to look at it. I don't think that's the way Gareth Southgate will look at it himself, which I don't want to defend any decision that he might make, because I've said it, I've been very clear on my stance on Greg Berhalter, basically, in my opinion, almost the same managers, but with Gareth Southgate, I've made my opinion clear on him in terms of him not being good enough to take England to the next level. But then again, I do think there's certain times that I've admired his bravery in terms of going with what he believes. And I will not blame him if he goes with a little bit more of a not pragmatic setup, but a pragmatic approach. Now, I'm really not gonna defend him going to a back five or playing a defensive double pivot, because then again, I think you're just leading yourself. I think that, you know, allows other teams to, you know, retain the ball more in midfield to really make you suffocate. And I think at the end of the day, that was what, you know, that's what did England at the World Cup 2018 against Croatia down that stretch, in the European Championship final down the stretch against Italy. I think that back five, that double pivot, ended up getting just too sucked in behind, and I think they struggled to come out and play out, and they really suffered. And I'll see that happening again against the better team. So I just want to see how England approach this. I want to see Serbia and whether or not they play both Vlahovic and Mitrovic. If they believe they can, you know, they did that at the World Cup. You know, they weren't able to get out of the group stages, but I don't think that was the problem. But are they willing to try that experiment again, or are they going to choose one? And if that's the case, I think you kind of have to go by game-by-game basis based on the you know, now if it's a game that you want to play morally in transition, you'd probably go with a guy like Vlahovic. But if you want to play more you know, it's a game that you're gonna have more opportunities, create more opportunities. Then you want to go with the direct nature of Mitrovic, who, you know, if you put in a ball in the box. By the way, at the thing that should concern you for England is you put in one quality ball, Mitrovic will take advantage of it, and then once he takes advantage of it, then Serbia are able to, you know, get numbers behind the ball and really defend for their lives, which I don't think. I think that would be a nightmare scenario if England to get put in that sort of position. I'm gonna go with. I'm gonna go with a draw on this one. I think this game finishes 1-1. Yeah, I'm gonna go with the 1-1 draw.